Hello, my name is Michael Kaler, and I am the lab manager of the Giam Diffraction Facility, located at the University of Tennessee, Knoxville. This video will demonstrate how to create a batch program to allow for automatic sample alignment. We will first set up individual measurement programs and then insert them into a batch program. To begin creating the individual programs, we can click either this button here or go to File, New Program. We want to make sure that it is an optimized program. Okay. First, I want to check here in configuration to make sure that these are correct. I see that my program defaults to the HTK1200N stage. That's our high temperature in situ stage. For the purposes of this video, let's pretend that I wanted to create this program for the XY platform with Z adjustment, our XYZ stage. So I will choose this one for this example. It says that these settings will be cleared for this configuration, which is fine because we haven't made any settings. Diffracted beam path. I'm going to be performing powder diffraction or a theta to theta scan using the pixel detector. So that will be diffracted beam path 1. This says that settings will be cleared again. That's okay. Now we can go into the settings and we have some options here. What you can do is insert your hardware settings here that you will use for alignment. And if you do that, once your program runs, it will check your settings and make sure that they are all correct. If not, it will warn you so that you can find a way to correct your mistake and move forward. However, different measurement techniques will require different prefix modules and optics. As such, I'm not going to set these here. You should be able to see that information in our measurement tutorial videos. You'll know what to use for alignment based off of those. For now though, at the very least, if you don't set up anything else, I do recommend that you come down here to detector and choose which one you will use. Personally, I am using the pixel detector, so I will choose that. I want to make sure that it is receiving slit 0D. I will change my active length to 0.1 and hit tab on the keyboard. We see that it changed the active length slightly and gave me 3 active channels. Now I will click OK. The first axis that we will scan will be 2 theta. In order to optimize that, we want to choose Go to Maximum. What that means is that it will scan in 2 theta, it will find the maximum of whatever peak appears, and then it will change the 2 theta position of the detector to match up to the maximum intensity position. For 2 theta, I find the range of 0.25 to work well. Your step size should be 1/100th of the range, which would make this 0.0025. Time per step, I find 0.2 to work well. That gives us a 22 second experiment time. Let's go up here and File, Save As. I have this set up automatically to go to my YouTube folder, but if you need to click around and find where you want to save this, go ahead and do that. I'm going to call this XYZ stage so that I know what configuration this program will work with. It is a 2 theta scan and we are performing a direct beam alignment. I will hit enter on the keyboard. The next type of scan is omega. Typically, because we are a user facility, we have a lot of different types of samples come through the lab, which means that we have a wide variety of peak shapes for omega. Sometimes they will be very broad and far away from zero, and sometimes they will be very sharp and may be close to zero. In order to ensure that I capture at least some sort of peak, I set the range to be 5 degrees, which would make the step size 0.05. And the time per step stays the same. If you predominantly run the same type of samples, such as thin films on a substrate of some sort, and they always have very sharp peaks that are close to zero, you may want to change the range to something like 1 and the step size to 0.01. For my purposes, because we handle a lot of different types of samples, I'm going to leave this at 5 and 0.05. We can now save this. I'll left click here once and change this to omega. Save. Now we want to change this to go to maximum first derivative. That means that it will scan the axis, it will find the derivative of the curve, and it will move the axis position to match up with the maximum point on the first derivative curve. For this, we want our scan axis to be z. Again, because we have a wide variety of samples entering the lab, they will all have different thicknesses. So to capture the feature that we want to capture in this scan, I need to first have this be a pretty large range. So I will set this up to be 10 millimeters, which makes the step size 0.1 millimeters. Time per step still remains the same. Again, if you have the same type of sample that is always the same height, then you might be able to set this up to be just 1, and then your step size to be 0.01. But I like to set a large range to begin with. Let's go over here to File, Save As. I'll click there once, change this to Z-Rough. Enter. And then once this rough scan gives us an approximate position that we need to be at for our sample, we can now change this to 1 and 0.01 to do a finer type of scan. Come up here, File, Save As. Left click that, change this to Fine, and Enter. Now that we have all of our individual scans saved, we can create a batch program to perform our alignment. Let's create a new program. This is exactly what we want, General Batch. We see our correct configuration here, XYZ platform. Okay. We have a very different looking type of window. We see here that we have command lines, and here we have items that we can insert into the program. First, we want to insert a batch setting. Left click. We are on beam path 1, so that's good. I will come here to X-ray PhD, and I will make sure that it is switched on, and I will set it so that it is 45 kilovolts and 40 milliamps. Let's go to Find Calibration Offsets. We are going to change them and clear them, just in case someone previously saved offsets. We will do the same thing under Sample Offsets, change them and clear them. Click OK. We now want to insert another batch setting. This time, we want to be under the Position tab, and I will check 2 theta, omega, and z. This is for the XYZ stage. I will change this to 0 and this to 0. There are different types of stages and different situations where maybe you want to 0 x and y or phi and chi. I will let you determine that. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section below, and let me know what sample stage you have so that we can discuss it and figure out what would work best for you. But I will click OK. We are now ready to begin aligning. So I will enter a measurement program, come over here to Program, Browse, and if you don't see your programs here, you can browse and find them. I have mine here though, so I will do it that way. want to start with the 2θ program, so I will open it. You can save the measurement to file if you want. It's not all that important. I don't usually save it, so I will uncheck it. Click OK. Now we see that appear there. Next, we will insert a batch setting. We will go to position, put a check mark next to Z, and I will change that to 5 millimeters. If you perform your alignment and don't see the feature that you need to see for your Z alignment, you may need to change this value to a larger number. Again, if you have problems, please leave them in the comment section below so I can try to help you out. Click OK. Now we are ready to insert another measurement program. We will browse, and this time we will do the rough Z alignment. I will uncheck Save and click OK. Next, we will insert another measurement program. Go to Browse. We want to perform our omega alignment. I will double click, uncheck, and OK. Finally, one last measurement program. Browse. We want to choose our Z-fine. Double click, uncheck, and OK. During alignment, omega and Z are coupled, which means that if one changes, then the other typically changes. If you go back and forth and keep measuring them, eventually they stabilize. We could insert these manually. I could go in here, insert another measurement program, make it the omega program. Or we could left-click here on the left-hand side, hold Shift on the keyboard, and left-click here to highlight the two steps that need to be repeated. We can then come down here to Cycles, and I will repeat these three times. Click OK. We see here that we have cycles of three, and this is a period to indicate that it goes along with this three. What happens is that it will perform the rough Z alignment, then it will come down here to perform omega, it will then perform Z fine, it will go back to omega, then go to Z fine, and it will cycle omega and Z fine a total of three times. From my experience, that is enough iterations in order to have the omega and Z value stabilize. But again, every situation can be different, so you might just want to watch your alignment and make sure that your values have stabilized. If not, you could just change this value to a larger number. Click down here on the last row, and then we will insert batch settings. We will go to our fine calibration offsets, change them. This time, however, we want to apply offsets. We will put a check mark by left-clicking next to 2θ and omega. Make sure that they are both zero. That will save the offset that the program has determined. Click OK, and you have now created your batch program for alignment. Make sure that you go to File, Save As. I will just type this one, the XYZ stage. This is auto alignment, and it is the batch program. Enter. And that is pretty much it. If you would like to learn what all of these alignments do, please watch our different data collection tutorial videos. At the time of recording this video, we have a standard powder or gonio type scan using the XYZ stage posted. That shows you what all of these alignments do. Our future plans are to include the high temperature stage and also the XYZ stage while performing grazing incidence X-ray diffraction. If those sound interesting to you, please check out our channel to see if they are posted. Or you could subscribe and turn on notifications to be notified when we do post new videos. If you have found this helpful at all, we would really appreciate a like, comment, or subscription. Any of these things really help us out by letting YouTube know that people like this content and are helped by it. YouTube will then show it to more people who can also be helped. If you have made it this far into the video, thank you for watching, and I hope you have a great day.